Hi, Lonnie Mackley here. I just want to talk to you a little bit today about something that's pretty important and affects a lot of people, and that's how do you heal a sexually perverted or sexually perverse mind? And a lot of times when we, you know, think of sexual perversion, we just think of child molesters or rapists or people like that. But the truth is, most of us are sexually perverted, and the reason being is that we're constantly viewing sexual perversion in different forms, and this works on your mind, and whatever truth that you had stored there sexually just begins to get more and more twisted and contorted until you have a sexually perverse mind, especially if you're viewing porn. Porn is nothing but a form of sexual perversion in different ways. Sexual rightness is God created man and woman. They were meant to be married, to have sex exclusively with one another for the purpose of creating children, mutual intimacy, and mutual pleasure. Anything beyond that is sexual perversion. Even masturbation is sexual perversion. But the thing is when you're viewing porn or you're reading romance novels or you're watching soap operas, all these things twist your mind and they pervert your mind sexually, where all of a sudden, you know, things like having an affair, you know, it glamorizes all of these things in our mind, and so people start fantasizing about it because it feels good to, you know, kind of have your own kind of Star Trek holodeck in your mind where you're the star and you get to do whatever you want. But the problem is it begins to really twist your mind, and it also attracts evil spirits that come and they'll push you to engage in more and more perverse activity. You'll notice with pornography, it's progressive, and the more that you view it, the more that you'll view more and more perverse stuff until your mind is so full of perverted images. It makes normal sex really hard. And frankly, you can burn yourself out sexually just from viewing porn too much, because it takes your normal desires and perverts them so badly that you can have a hard time getting sexually aroused or enjoying just normal sex, because you've kind of gone so far down the road of perversion that normal sex no longer appeals to you. And so, you know, we get like this, our minds get twisted, or maybe when you were young, you misdeveloped sexually. Maybe, you know, while you were developing sexually when you were young, you made different judgments about your parents, about their genders, about yourself, and so it perverted your sexual desires, and you grew up that way, and now you don't know how to change those desires, and you feel completely hopeless. You think, I can never be normal. Maybe you said this to yourself, I just want to be normal. And whether you've viewed too much porn, whether you've got sexually perverse desires, whatever it is, there is a way for you to be normal. But it takes a little bit of work. It takes God's miracles, His power to help you, but you can be normal. And that's what we're going to talk about today. And just understand that no matter how far down the road that you've gone with perversion, God can bring you back if you're willing to really cry out to Him and ask Him to help you. You know, Jesus said, whatever you need to do to stay out of hell, do it. And He gave examples, pluck your eye out, cut your hand up. And He said, you know, be as extreme as you have to be to keep yourself from going to hell. Because Jesus has seen hell. He knows what's there. He knows that's real. And no matter how much we think that it's just a fantasy, hell is a real place. And there may even be people that you've known that are there right now. And if they came here, they would tell you it's real and to stay out of there. And Jesus said, do whatever you have to do to stay out of there. So that's why we have to get things right, because the abnormal is normal now. So you can run through your whole life thinking that you're normal just by living in the abnormal, and then when you get in front of God, which He is normal, then you're going to realize just how abnormal your normality was here. And so it's best to get the truth in you, get in what's normal now, because you're going to have to give an account for your life. Listen to this. This is out of the Bible. It says, do you not know that the wicked will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived. Neither the sexually immoral, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor male prostitutes, nor homosexual offenders, nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor drunkards, nor slanderers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. And so it's telling you right there. And if you don't inherit the kingdom of God, you go to the other place. And, you know, you can either believe it now or believe it later, but that's the truth. God's the one that manufactured humankind. He sets up the rules. He has all the power. So what He says goes, and you can either, you know, ignore it and pay the consequences, or you can listen now, believe it, and then end up being with the Lord, being in heaven, and with all those that you love when you die, because you wise up, and no matter what everybody else does around you, you need to wise up, and you need to be able to listen to the wisdom of God, and follow through. You need to do this for yourself, because there is no purgatory. There's no second or third chances. Once your heart stops beating, that's it for you. Your spirit and soul leave your body. You're going to stand there and look at your body laying there, and you can't get back into it. And then you're going to go, you're going to be pulled into another realm, and you're going to have to face God. And so it's best to believe it now. And don't just skate through your whole life thinking that you'll have time at the end, because a lot of people don't. My own mother was killed by a drunk driver when she was young, just from out partying. She thought she had her whole life ahead of her, and that's how we all think. But when it's done, and you can't get back into your body. So let's just get into this. And like I said, with pornography, it perverts your thinking so badly that you begin to wear these like porn-colored glasses everywhere you go. After that, you're scanning for porn in real life, and you're going to get very embarrassed having to try to be around people. You're going to have these porn images pop up in your head at some of the worst times. It's going to affect your sex life with your partner, especially if you're trying to introduce perversion. And it's really going to mess you up. So when you run around with these porn-colored glasses, so to speak, you're, whether you like it or not, you're viewing porn in real life, in a sense, and you're going to be undressing people. Whatever perversions you have, that's going to mix into how you see things, and it's just going to be very uncomfortable for you. So let's talk about how to get free of it, and whether you've gotten, like I said, whether you have sexually abnormal desires, fetishes, whatever it is, from your early childhood. The secret of it is first of all, learn the lie and the truth. I told you the truth, what it was, real sex. The guy that manufactured sex created your body to have sex so that it was a gift for you. Created it for a husband and wife to enjoy, to have kids, and that's it. And you can tell by the way that the body's made how normal sex is. I don't need to go into that. And so it's not that hard to figure out. But Satan wants to pervert that. He wants to pervert everything that God's made. He wants to get you to abuse it so that you can sin against God, so that he can take you to hell when you die. And so you're the one that has to do this for yourself. You've been given free will here, so you have to use it the right way. Number two, starve the lie, feed the truth. The lie is all pornography, anything beyond the description that I gave you is sexual perversion, including pornography, sexual fantasy, those kinds of things. That's sexual perversion. That's the lie. You need to starve the lie. Don't feed the lie by cruising porn. Of course, your body's going to have sexual needs, but you're going to have to learn to either meet your needs in the right way, or you're going to have to learn to endure the need until it passes. And that's just the truth of it. It's not worth your soul. Like I was saying in Mark 9, Jesus said, do whatever you have to keep from going to hell. Like I said, number two is starve the lie, feed the truth. And also think of Tito. Think in truth only. Don't let the lie slip back in when you're getting tempted. Think in truth only. Jesus said, whoever looks at a woman to lust after has committed adultery already in his heart. So when you're imagining and fantasizing, you're guilty of the same crime. So what you do in your mind, you're just as guilty as if you did it in real life. So train your mind, discipline your mind, let God's word transform your mind, and you can be free of this. And in time, you'll retrain your pathways in your mind. Number three, like I said, meet right needs in right ways. You're going to have sexual needs, so learn to meet them in the right way with the spouse, or to abstain, or wait for a nocturnal release, whatever you need to do. Number four, understand that you'll be held accountable for what you do here. If you abuse the gifts that God gives you sexually, you'll be held accountable. Number five, ask the Holy Spirit to help you. There's a video I did about being baptized in the Holy Spirit. He's the counselor that when you're getting baptized and filled with the Holy Spirit, he counsels you from the inside out, and he repairs you from the inside out sexually. And it may take a little time, but it can be done with his help. And also, like I said, abstain and endure. And this can be hard because you're so used to pleasure gratification, of instantly gratifying all of your needs and abusing pleasure, that the idea of not gratifying a pleasure is really foreign to most of us. But you're going to have to get used to not doing those things. Like Jesus said, you're going to have to get used to doing right and to stop doing wrong. And in time, you will be transformed into somebody that has normal desires, somebody that is trained to do right. And doing wrong will be foreign to you after that. So I hope this has helped you a little bit. I've got a website called Spirit Led Recovery from Addiction that can also help. And there's other videos on here too. Okay, bless you, my friend. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.